Hi everybody, today is March 17th, 2013. You might check the labels of your clothing that have so-called fake fur, especially if it was made in China. It might come from an animal called raccoon dog, which is a member of the dog family. So that coat that you might be wearing might actually have fur from man's best friend. And leave it to the Chinese, right? Century 21, under fire under fox fur. Marcus Jacobs coats are revealed to have been made with pelts from real raccoon dog. Now this is a member of the canine family. The Humane Society of the United States conducted a 5-month investigation into labeling of fox fur garments. The fur trim on three Mark and Mark Jacobs jackets contained the fur of raccoon dogs, which are often skinned alive in China. So the next time I see someone walking down the street with fur trim that looks similar to that, I'm going to think, oh my god, they're wearing dog. Clothing sold as fake fur at Century 21 has been revealed to contain real animal fur. It's also other places. It's not just one store. 5-month undercover investigation by the Humane Society of the United States found that several garments trimmed with fox fur were actually made with the pelts of Chinese raccoon dog, a species related to domestic dogs that is often trimmed alive for its soft coat. Among the so-called missed label items were three Mark and Mark Jacob coats, which were ordered from the discount retail chain's website, DNA Info reported. Other offering garments purchased from downtown and Upper West Side stores include an infant hooded jacket by Trust Fund Baby, it says, a JNBY hoodie, and a Save the Queen stole, all of which contain rabbit fur or possibly hair. But the labels of the three designer jackets revealed they were trimmed with real raccoon fur from China, and laboratory tests later found they were actually raccoon dog. A full breakdown of the Humane Society's finding has been published on its website. The investigation results were supported by hidden camera footage from the Upper West Side branch of Century 21, recorded by New York State Assembly member Lyndon Rosenthal, who led the investigation with the Humane Society. The team asked a number of sales staff if they knew whether any item featured real or fake fur. In several cases, the staffer checked the garment label to confirm an answer that the item was made with synthetic fur. Another in-store staffer said they just didn't know. And it shows two different images here. I'm not quite sure what it's supposed to be, but it says not so facts. An infant's trust baby top left and Save the Queen stole right are revealed to contain real fur in their apparent fake trims. And it's showing here the labels for the Trust Fund Baby Top and Save the Queen Stole make no mention of the fur in their trims. There's another jacket. Rosenthal later said in a statement, many people want to avoid wearing fur at all. And for them, knowing whether the garments they are about to purchase is made with real or fake fur is just as important a factor in determining whether to buy it as is the price. Indeed, it was she who introduced the fur labeling law, and the state passed in 2007. Manufacturers are also legally required to disclose the kind of fur used and the country of origin. She said that the investigation team discovered other items in violation of the labeling laws at Century 21 as well, such as unlabeled infant sweater made with rabbit fur. Here they're showing the label. It says 60% acrylic, 40% of wool, but doesn't account for these patches of fur. Anybody who doesn't want to buy animal fur should be very angry that a product that they're trying to avoid is being misrepresented as a product they may want to buy. It goes on to say that Century 21 had issued a statement that says it does not create garment labels. The manufacturers do. It is the manufacturer's responsibility to provide an accurate account of materials used in the garment and to be transparent with the consumer before his or her purchase. We respect the diligence of the Humane Society of the United States to uphold state and federal law in regards to garment labeling. Many shoppers were horrified to hear that some of the fox fur garments were in fact made of raccoon dogs. Now remember, that's a type of domestic dog that they slaughter, skin alive. Now you would think the purchaser who buys the products for the stores would have recognized, looking at the product, should know the products they're buying, would know that these were in fact not fake fur. So even if you don't have a problem with wearing fur, But say you have an allergy to rabbits, or you have an allergy to dog, would the process of washing and cleaning before it was, you know, put into this fabric, would that, you know, lessen the effects of allergies? I don't know. But it should be on the label, and it is required by law. And this is another example why we should not purchase things from China. Reminds me of the article I did last year about the dog bowls that were radioactive because they were using recycled metal that was contaminated with radiation. Pet treats that kill our pets. Children's clothing, Halloween costumes, toys with lead, you know, paint. God, quit buying from China. All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.